I'm Brigham Larson with Brigham Larson Pianos. This piano has been a long time coming, and I'm really excited about this total transformation of this 1895 Kranich and Bach that was in absolutely terrible condition. It was such a long time ago. I don't even remember if we did a before video. I'm pretty sure we did. Sometimes we remember to do them, sometimes we forget. I hope we did, because this is such a dramatic turnaround. I mean, both in cosmetics as well as the piano itself, the functionality and the instrument and everything. Okay, let's look at the cosmetics first. That's the obvious. So this piano was just totally, like, it was dark, it was ugly, chipped up, damaged, and we had no idea that there was even this veneer underneath. Look at this veneer. Unbelievable. And so when we got this all stripped down and we saw the veneer underneath, we called up the people who own the piano and said, okay, you got to come check this out. We need to just do a natural finish so we can really highlight this amazing veneer. And they agreed. I was very pleased that they agreed, because that looks so darn good. And check out the petals, the original petals. They've been plated. We plate them here in-house. Ooh, we're actually next to the plating room. Should we go check out the plating room?
You wanna?
Sure.
Watch the plate. I don't know if the light's working.
Oh, yeah. The light's not working. Can try
a flashlight tour.
It's not very good, is it?
Not so much. Oh, here's a light.
Kinda. Anyway, you can see, so the pals come in, just looking terrible. And this is our, most of them are done right now. Looking good. Anyway, most pianos we end up doing in brass. Most metal hardware we end up doing in brass, but we can do nickel. And we actually had a request for copper, and we did it.
Which kind of looks like rose gold.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. Anyway, so that's the cosmetics. Okay, let's check out the inside. So come on over here. This piano was on the inside in abominable condition. I don't use that word very often.
That's a first.
Yeah.
Abominable.
So, man, that looks good now. You can see all the repairs on the soundboard. If you look closely, you can see the shims. Got like 11, I think there might be, 12 under there. I want to say I counted at one point, I think 13 total. There might be one under this plate. The soundboard sounds great now. It's amazing what when you rebuild a soundboard like that, how it goes from just sounding thuddy, like a... That actually doesn't sound terrible, but like a plastic bench or something, or a, I don't know what a wall sounds like, but it has no like life in it. And then you rebuild it. We put the crown back in it, which is the bend. A lot of times it'll just be a totally flattened soundboard. So we push it up from the bottom, put in those shims. And then when we take out the pressure from beneath, it settles back to, or it stays in that crown, and it just sounds good. Like the life comes out of it again. It sounds amazing. And then it's refinished just to look good. Same with the plate. This plate is all refinished, gilded. This is hand drawn. Over here one more time so we can highlight the bridge work. All the bridges on this, you can see the seam under here of the cap of the bridge. There you can see so from the seam down, that's all original. I mean, that's been sanded down and lacquered, but that's original wood. Whereas from the seam up, all of that is a new bridge cap. And we do a pattern of the old bridge, so we get it exactly right. Do a pattern with plastic and make it, you know, spot on. Sometimes we'll will like straighten this line or something like that. Sometimes the line of these pins won't be exactly straight. It'll kind of be crooked. So I'll straighten that out maybe, but we'll stick to the spacing. Same with the bridge here. All of that is redone. You see, same thing. You can see the seam right there where I've got the new bridge. And we redo the height, the height of the bridge according to the new soundboard height and the placement of the plate. That's called down bearing. Got a new down bearing on there. Not too much, not too little. New dampers. The entire action is brand new. If you can see down in there, I'm not going to pull the action for the video, but I guess just have to take my word for it. All the hammers are new. You can see those hammers in there. And the shanks that they're attached to. And you can see that nice regulation. Boom. 1/8 inch. And a little 1/16 inch drop. Looks nice. Ooh. Yeah. The whippings are new. Just the whole action. Keys are new. This piano did have ivory, but it was in such rough condition that it is just not worth it. I have had some comments on some of my videos, people that prefer that I keep the ivory. They think it's a shame that we get rid of the ivory and put plastic on like this, but I just have to disagree. When ivory is in terrible condition, I would rather have plastic that's in perfect condition. And when I say plastic, a lot of times the implication or the feeling is that it's like cheap garbage, junk plastic. But I mean, this is the same plastic that's used on, you know, $100,000 pianos. So I think it looks great. And even frankly, ivory that's in good condition, like if it's in say like B plus condition, and we salvage it and we use it, a lot of times it just, I don't know, in my opinion, it sort of looks weird if it, you know, if there's some discoloration, some yellow, maybe a little bit of cracking. If it's in like perfect condition, A plus, then it looks great. But if that's not the case, then yeah, I think it looks much better to just go with the plastic. And there's a surprise on this piano too. Let's check out this surprise. I can find it here, maybe. So 1895, and one other thing that I'll mention that was kind of interesting when we pulled the plate to do the to do all the soundboard and bridge work. You can see it right here. There's a burn mark. We discovered this big burn mark here. And then when we pulled the plate out, what we discovered is back here, it wasn't so much on this side, but over on this side was a huge weld on the cast. A lot of people say you can't weld cast, but you can. It's trickier, and you have to have a special welder and a lot of patience, but it can be done. And so that was kind of a surprise that this whole area had been welded. The repair was well done, and from a structural standpoint, it worked well. But the only thing that I could think of is that must have been done like probably at the factory, I would think, because I don't think anyone has ever pulled the plate since 1895. So I'm thinking they probably welded it at the factory, like something happened maybe at the factory, maybe the cast didn't settle correctly or something happened, maybe they put some tension on it, or maybe they dropped it in the factory, you know, 126 years ago, something like that. And rather than redoing a new plate or scrapping the whole project, starting over, they just decided to weld it. But they welded it in place, I guess, and they burned the side of the piano. So I don't know when the people that owned this piano, said that there's no way that, that it could have been done. Since then, okay, I'm trying to find a good. Maybe let's do this. Install this, obviously, if we can install it on an 1895 piano, we can install it on any piano, and we have installed it on even, I think going back, piano 1880s. So it's, I think it's just super fun, and it's such a merging of different worlds. You've got this old family piano, you've got the complete restoration, and then the modern player system put on it with like 120,000 songs or something like that, so tons of classical, tons of Broadway. They've got Hamilton and like, I don't know how many musicals they have on here. All this Frank Sinatra, Nat King Cole, and I mean, you name it, literally like thousands and thousands of artists. Super fun, so cool. And the piano itself, it's just like, sounds great.
That's a good bass.
Actually being delivered today. I'm gonna be sad to see it go, but happy for the family that's getting this treasure, this completely restored family heirloom treasure. So there it is. Thanks for watching.